माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ़ यू एंड आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ़ यू टू NIT अगरतला, पर्टिकुलरली फॉर द न्यू कमर्स हु हैज़ टेकन एडमिशन टू दिस सेमेस्टर. आई वुड लाइक टू इन्फॉर्म यू दैट माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर राम नरेश राय, आई एम ए प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन इंजीनियरिंग. एट द सेम टाइम्स आई एम टेकिंग केयर ऑफ डीन स्टूडेंट्स वेलफेयर as a Dean SW2. Further, I would like to inform you that in Dean SW sections we have a Dean, then Associate Dean, then we have Chief Warden and Supervisor in the different wardens and supervisor in the different hostels. So presently we have a two Deans, Student Welfare, Dean SW1 and Dean SW2, and then we have a two Associate Dean, Associate Dean, and then we have Chief Warden, and under the Chief Warden we have the different hostels, and having that hostels having the wardens. In each hostels maybe 2, maybe 4, maybe 6, depends on the capacity of the hostels, we have the wardens, number of wardens. And then again each hostels have the supervisor who will look after the day-to-day activities of the hostels. Now I can say that as and when you people will be coming, and our aim is to create a state and holistic living experience and to provide clean, safe and comfortable accommodations for the students of NIT Agartala, and to be the center of excellence in provision of students accommodation service and to provide home away from home. So as and when you will be coming to NIT Agartala, you will feel that it is something like a home feelings. We have a two big hostels. One is Arjavat hostels having capacity of 1000, then another is RNT hostels having the capacity of 1500, and then we have another hostels, Gomti, Havra and Dhalai hostels, each having the 120 capacity. And then we have the girls hostel, that is Gargi hostels, having the capacity of 500 to accommodate. And you can see the photographs of this photographs, first, second and third, you can see this is the RNT hostels where is having the 1500 capacity and single occupancy. And if you see the third photographs, that is dining space where you have the dining facilities. So in that hostel we have the four dining hall, ground floor, first floor and both the sides. So altogether four dining spaces we have. So there are, and each dining hall capacity is nearly 300, more than 400. So one students can come and they can have the comfortably dinner, lunch, breakfast and so on. As and when you will be coming to the hostels, you have to follow the certain guidelines or rule and regulations to maintain the hostels calm, quiet, peace and harmony inside the hostels. The hostelers should cooperate to keep the hostel neat and clean for healthy ambience. Ragging in any form is prohibited, and if anybody is found, the raggers will obey the orders of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, and it is a punishable. Fighting among each other in a group or an individual is a punishable offense at any circumstances, and if you will be found guilty, you will be punished 5000 rupees in each cases and every individuals. Further, you will be given a particular room will be allotted, and it will be found or observed that you have interchanged your room. In that case, again, you will be able to pay the penalty of 5000 rupees, as well as again you have to go to your originally allotted room. The personal laptop without external speaker, mobile phone, power bank, are only allowed to use. Use of any other electrical appliances is strictly prohibited. Cooking is not allowed inside the hostel's room, and if it will be found, you are liable to punishment of financially. Using any kind of motor vehicles by the hosteler is strictly prohibited in the campus premises. Smoking or chewing or consumption of alcohol is also prohibited, and it is not permissible in any form. Any unauthorized accommodations by the hostelers for friends, visitors, relatives at the hostel room is strictly prohibited and may attract financial penalty against each individual. Photographs, pasting, drawing, writing on the wall of the room or the common area of the hostel is strictly prohibited. Do not write the name, roll number or department on the door of the room. The birthday celebration inside the hostel room or hostel corridor is strictly prohibited. Hosteler is not allowed to remain absent from the hostel at night time without written permissions from the supervisor or the wardens. Using the roof of any hostels or mess is strictly prohibited. Boys hostels for UG courses from first year to final year and PG first year are not allowed to stay outside the hostels from night 10 p.m. 10:30 p.m. to 5 a.m. without permissions. Similarly, for the PhD scholars and PG second years, those who are associated with experimental work are not allowed to stay outside the hostel from 11:30 p.m. to 5 a.m. without permissions. Girls hostelers are not allowed to stay outside the hostels from 6 p.m. to 5:30 a.m. without permissions. In exceptional cases, further approval is mandatory from the hostel authority of NIT Agartala. The intentional damage of any items or hostel rooms or the corridor is liable of occupant to get it repaired or replaced, or for monetary fine will be also imposed. Misuse of water, electricity and other facilities are liable to disciplinary actions. Hosteler is solely responsible for keeping the valuable belongings with him or her. Playing the outdoor games which may damage the hostel property is strictly prohibited inside the hostels. Now, as and when you will be in the hostels, we have to follow the mess timing for taking the breakfast, lunch and dinner. For breakfast, in all the seasons, 7:30 a.m. to 9 a.m. Lunch, 12:30 p.m. to 2:15 p.m. and dinner, 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. And as and when you are coming to the dining space, or you can say the mess, there also you have to follow the certain guidelines of NIT Agartala. The hostler should be calm, quiet and maintain the peace and harmony inside the mess. The hostler should cooperate to keep the mess neat and clean for healthy ambience. Mess is compulsory for all the hostlers and food should not be taken outside, and they have to take the food inside only. The mess will be closed during the vacations, and any students willing to stay in the during the vacation period has to get approval by applying through MIS. Leave application must be submitted through MIS 5 days prior to the date of absence from the mess, and only 8 days normal leave is allowed in a month. Students should cooperate in case of unintentional delay to prepare the food due to unavoidable circumstances. No hosteler is allowed to take any food or articles or utensils from the mess. Food is allowed in hostel rooms on medical ground with the prior permission from the manager or supervisor of the hostels. Photographs, pasting, writing is strictly prohibited in the mess area. Intentional damage of any item in the mess is liable to compensate the damage. Damage of any property such as door, window, electrical fittings, toilet fittings, glass panes, etc. will lead to disciplinary actions. Misuse of water, particularly washing hand by drinking water, electricity, other facilities in the mess are liable to punishment. Playing of any game inside the mess is strictly prohibited. Now I would like to inform you that we have a very good sports complex inside the campus and its name is Atal Bihari Vajpayee Sports Complex, and it's having the very big area. And then we have the indoor game facilities, outdoor game facilities, and so on. Now you can see the look of your sports complex. The first photographs will show you this is the main gate or entrance of the this sports complex, and second photographs you can see this is the inside the sports complex. We have indoor facilities like swimming pool, badminton, basketball, then gymnasium and other facilities, and you can see there in the photographs. Now this photographs, first photograph is showing outside from the tennis and badminton court, and inside and next photographs you can see the some of the students are playing the badminton. Now we have the images of the some existing facilities available in our sports complex. That is a football ground, gymnasium we have, then you have badminton court, indoor basketball court, yoga center, table tennis, and so on. I feel pleasure to inform you that NIT Agartala used to conduct inter NIT sports meets. In all NIT together, annually inter sports activity is conducted, and different NITs is going to host some of the games. And like last 3-4 years, NIT Agartala is also hosting the some of the games under inter NIT sports meet. And the some photographs which I am showing you here, we have the students of NIT Pondicherry, NIT Calicut, NIT Durgapur, and many other NITs. So we have shown you the some of the photographs. There are many institutions from the all over India NIT systems, so they have come and participated in the inter sports activities. Now I would like to inform you that we have one committee which can look after the regular maintenance of the sports complex and any events which will be conducted inside the sports complex, and particularly from the all some departments, from the boys hostels, from the girls hostels, from the students bodies, representatives are the member of this committee. So I would like to inform you that myself, Dr. R. N. Dai, I am a chairman of this committee. Then Dr. Sukanto Goswami, he is a physical education officer, he is a convener. Then we have Dr. U. K. Bera, he is associate dean, he is member. Mr. Anupam Pal, he is a sports officer, he is also one of the member. Then Mr. R. K. Bhagendra Methi, chief warden, he is also member. Dr. Mitra Varun Sarkar, he is a faculty in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, he is also one of the member and the warden of the R&T hostels. Mrs. Asmita Das, she is a faculty in the Department of Computer Science Engineering and member of that committee. Then we have Dr. Nandini Rai, she is the warden of the girls hostels and faculty in the Department of Physics, she is also one of the member. Then we have a Vice President of the Gymkhana. He is a member, ex-officio. Then General Secretary Sports of Gymkhana. He is also an ex-officio members. So these are the committee who will look after the regular activities, maintenance, and other activities of the sports complex. Then we have the different facilities in the sports complex. We can say that we have the football ground of 2. Then we have cricket ground 1. Then we have cricket net practice 1, but it is under the construction, means it is upcoming. Then we have a basketball court 2, then volleyball court 2, then we have kho-kho court 2, kabaddi 2, then we have handball court 1, badminton court 4, lawn tennis 2, indoor swimming pool, which is coming up. We have a 1, which is totally covered. Then we have one gymnasium for the boys, and another is existing and another is upcoming. And for the girls also, we have gymnasium, then table tennis, carom, and chesses. These facilities are available in every hostels. My dear students, as and when you will be coming to the sports complex, there also you have to follow the certain guidelines to maintain the sports complex neat and clean. And you should have the sportsman esprit as and when coming to play the games in the sports complex. The users are all faculty members, all staffs, all students of NIT Agartala. The keep calm and quiet to maintain the peace and harmony in the playground, court, and sports units. So you have to follow, you have to maintain it. Your playground, court, sports unit, and attached toilet facilities must be kept neat and clean enough for all. Any kind of empty food packet or bottle should not be thrown in the ground or court or sports unit. And if you will not follow, you are liable to monetary fine. Playing the proper entry in the register of a sports complex is compulsory for all the users at the time of entry as well as time of exit. No player can play the same game for more than one time on the same day at any circumstances. A smoking, consuming of alcohol, drinks, or supplying any of these items to others is strictly prohibited in the sports area, or we can say the entire campus. Do switch off lights, fan, any other electrical facilities at ground, court, sports unit when the game is over for the day. The ragging of any sort, verbal, physical, or psychological, is a crime and it is strictly prohibited in campus and off campus. Punishment for ragger will obey the order of Honorable Supreme Court of India. The fighting among each other in a group or individual related with the games and sports or misbehavior may lead to punishable offense at any circumstances. Any of the such happens, further disciplinary actions may be initiated and every individual will be liable to monetary fine or suspension or terminations of the users from the sports complex. All the users to play badminton, table tennis, lawn tennis, basketball are required to bring on racket, shuttlecock, other gear and proper shoes, etc. And these items are not provided by the NITA. Damage of property. All users are liable for any deliberate damage due to improper or inappropriate use. All sports activities should be performed in the respective playgrounds or a sports unit only. Some of the dangerous sports equipments, like javelin, discus and shot put. It is should not be left unattended and taken care of properly. Proper protective gear and measures should be taken at the time of use of such equipments in the game timing. The person suffering from the diabetes, hypertension or coronary artery disease, asthma, swelling feet, seizure disorder and any other disorder will not be allowed to use the gymnasium. There is no senior junior concept in during the games and sports facilities. Game and sports facilities is open to all equally. Outsider is not allowed to use the games and sports facilities at any circumstances. In any case is found, a strict security persons of an ITA or police personnel may be informed and they are going to face the inquiry against them. Decision will be made to be best of the referees or umpire's ability according to the laws of games and the spirit of the game. The decision of the referees or umpire will be the final and it has to be obeyed by all the students. Time for using games and sports must be strictly obeyed by all students at any circumstances. No excuse can be considered at any reason and disciplinary actions will be initiated with immediate effect if not obeyed. My dear students, I already said that we have a very big playground, we have a big sports complex area, and if you will talk about the area wise, we have 64,777 square meter, which is a big area. Then we have the indoor tennis, badminton courts, and their areas are also mentioned. If you can see the slides, you can see it. Then we have a multi-purpose indoor stadium. This is also a big size, having the seating capacity of the 1300 persons can sit and they can watch the match. Then you have a swimming pool that is also is bigger inside, and there nearly 500 persons can sit and they can see the matches. Then we have a administrative and gymnasium the buildings inside the sports complex. There we have some administrative office, and then we have a gymnasium facilities. Even medical units are also attached with that. We have a big football ground. Then we have mini cricket ground and parking facilities also. So I would like to say that we have a much more facilities, and only we are waiting for you people to come over here and stay 4 years with a healthy environment, clean environment, greenish environment, and our facilities is at par with the international standard. So I would like to thank each and everyone. And thank you.